Thank you, panelists, for sharing your thoughts and insights. A lot of learnings, you know, captured in a capsule today in today's session. The pandemic has taught us to be focused on the fundamentals of our business, to rethink the way we do business, and to be ready and adaptive to the changes in the external environment. When it comes to a business continuity plan, there is no one-size-fits-all approach. As we would have seen from the discussions today, one needs to take into account specific needs of each and every business and tailor-made the business plan and the business continuity plan in accordance with the business. Various risk mitigating strategies are being explored and put in place across business functions. To start with, contracts are being looked into with fine-tooth comb. The importance of drafting watertight provisions around force majeure, suspension of contracts, as well as the termination provisions. Do I have a right to suspend my performance or suspend my payment? Or do I have a right to exit in between a contract? Mediation and dialogue with the counterparties are being explored as conflict management in order to avoid litigations and associated costs with it. Communication is the key. When in doubt, set out our position clearly to the other side. In a dispute scenario, this helps greatly. As regards managing our workforce, the questions that need to be kept in mind would be, is reduction of workforce a solution, or should there be salary reductions across the board? One needs to strike a balance between interests of various stakeholders and business as a whole. Laying down a clear work from home policy so that professional standards and business efficiencies are achieved. Is work from home the new normal? Looks like the answer is yes for now. And in that case, one needs to see that the IT systems need to be robust to support a work from home, to invest in technology to support video conferencing, executing and managing contracts electronically, and to study the jurisprudence around it, ensuring that confidential data of the company is secured at any cost. Corporate governance practices need to be looked into. One needs to take a leaf out of what SEBI has prescribed for listed companies to disclose the impact of pandemic on the business. Transparent communications of the impact on business from time to time must also be done. Perhaps boards or committees thereof need to have meetings at more frequent intervals. Setting committees with the mix of board and senior management members in order to assess the business more frequently and at more frequent intervals. Hence, every level of the company must ensure that the business continues and must be able to preempt every kind of situation, preventing it from going out of control. Thank you.